What is up, guys? Look who I got here. Dave from Birdtricks. Finally, all of you people have been like, hey, talk to Birdtricks. Well, guess what? We're hanging out. It's been pretty awesome. Go check out their channel. We're shooting guns and doing training with Toruk and talking about Phoenix and all that. So you guys can go check that out, get updated on all that. We're here right now with Claudia from BlueMacawHouse. That's what her Instagram handle is. And is that what her YouTube is? Also, yeah. BlueMacawHouse. Check out Claudia. She's got two free flying birds. Does she have more birds than that free fly?
She has the two that free fly. That's it.
Yeah, so we're over here at a park over by my house. We're gonna take her birds out, fly them around. It's nice, it's not hot anymore.
It's perfect.
It was super hot earlier. Earlier it was miserable. But now it's super nice. Let's go check the birds out. Let's check out this little travel setup they got going on. Look how filthy the cars are, because earlier we were in Homestead. We got Sunshine, blue and gold, female. She's super cute. I love blue and gold. And then we have Vicky, right? Little cockatoo. You're cute. We're gonna fly these guys. It's gonna be super fun. The goal is I wanna teach Toruk how to fly. That would be awesome.
You could totally get Toruk to fly. He's already, like, he fledged properly.
Yeah.
Which means he knew the skills before he was clipped. That's huge. Like, when we started working with Sunshine, she was 9 months old. And she was clipped, and we taught her how to fly while she was clipped. We had another client in Orlando area, same thing, their blue and gold Tango was clipped, and we got them to fly. So most people, one, think that the bird's clipped and they can't fly anymore, but two, they also think you can't train them when they're clipped. And seeing how much you've already got him to grow out, like, and the bond and everything, just from what I saw today, I don't think there's any issue. Like, you'd be able to get there pretty fast.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That is exciting. Gotta get that diet on point.
Yeah, the diet's not so good right now.
That's why I got Birdtricks here. Gotta find these things out the hard way. At least we did it. Thank God for YouTube.
Hey guys. Come on, baby girl. Don't go eat my club.
Vicky.
And this is Sunshine.
Vicky and Sunshine.
Are you ready, girl? Come on.
You're so cute.
Let me on.
Look how pretty you are.
Hello. Come on. Beauties. Come on. Step up. Oh, ooh, that's good. Grab my head. I'm gonna grab my head.
This is pretty cool.
It's really cool.
Right?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Pretty awesome.
Well, it's good to know that I can.
Might be one of the coolest things I think I've ever seen. Came here to the park with your dragons.
So did you see that?
Oh yeah, lady? She was
I'm pretty
scared.
Pretty sure that's the neighbor that's giving you the complaint. She's out of here.
Amazing. So how long has she been free flying? Wow. Imagine bringing Toruk and Shiva to the park.
Hey, baby girl. Hi. What are you? Did you checking out this park?
On her tail, there's actually a GPS mount. You can see it just blinking a little bit. So that all talks to her phone and records all the data from the flight. So you can see how many miles she flew, how fast she flew, what her total altitude was. And through their app, you can play it all back in 3D. So you can see if they, you know, if it was on a hawk, for example, you could see the pattern as it goes up and dives.
That's so cool.
And just with this, like, you can kind of see, like, they're out of sight here. So you can look and see where did they actually fly. And it's remarkable what that records. But also for safety, it just clips on and off super easy. And makes it so that if you are free flying and you are not sure where the bird went, you're okay.
Pretty nifty.
Yeah, especially when you're in new locations and you don't know when something can get them spooky or whatever. Yeah. So it's better.
Reassurance, I'd be so scared letting, just, I couldn't imagine if something happened to Toruk, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Just losing him would be.
You know, training is always very important to be.
La la. La la. Beautiful voice.
You wanna sing?
La 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 la.
Ah, la la la.
She waves.
Yep.
So how do you could do that with target training with the stick and all that, like
so
you were showing me?
You wouldn't necessarily use target training to teach the wave, but it all kind of builds on itself. So the fact right now, Taruk's learning that click equals treat.
Right.
And so what can happen is you can capture, almost like taking a flash photography, like you can capture the moment when the bird, let's say, raises his foot to scratch his head, you can click. And then the bird's like, oh, what did I do to get the treat? And we'll repeat and offer that again, knowing that every click gets a treat.
Right.
So one of the easier ways to train the wave is you have them start to step up and you click before they actually do get to step up, because that's, you're naturally getting that behavior.
Gotcha.
So if you want, we can try to see if we can work on it. We also got the spin we're going on too, so.
Yeah, the spin.
But the clicker is really the key to
she wants to, do
to teaching them. It's a huge, huge part of it.
She wants to do one more, David.
Okay.
Her favorite one.
La 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 la.
Where's the Supergirl? Okay, you wanna do the Supergirl, all right. Supergirl!
Like, since I don't know this bird, I would start with a quick target and make sure that he knows, like, hey, are you good to train? And I want to make sure I'm getting aggressive. Okay, so that was pretty curious, right, versus aggressive. It was getting a little aggressive earlier, so that would tell me, like, okay, this bird wants to work with me. So anytime that you get stuck, you go back to where it was last working. Alright, so the next step would be for me to phase my hand out so he's not just like following it. And you'll find that you get to a certain point where they start to like beg. We're probably not gonna get there today, but. Do you want to give it a shot?
Yeah.
Okay, so the key is, why don't you take the treats? If you lose his attention for a second, just quickly flash those so he's like, oh yeah. And you'll notice like all of a sudden he'll be directed back to you. Mm-hmm. As you're using your finger to kind of go around, try to anticipate, like not get too far ahead of him. Mm-hmm. And try to, it's so distracting.
Can't do anything in this house.
So if you get too far ahead of him, then he's gonna get nervous that your hand's behind him. Mm-hmm. So try to like anticipate and just push. It's so hard to explain, but just push just within his boundaries where you know he's gonna do it.
Gotcha.
And I'll step back so you notice he's working with you.
See what I got.
Yeah. Perfect. All right, so as I was saying, it all starts with a diet, which is all this. So. This looks like it'd be super overwhelming, but it all comes down to the seasonal feeding system that's in this first one. And then when it's like, some people really have a hard time being like, oh, I'm gonna make lasagna, or I'm gonna do this and share it with a bird. There's like bird safe versions of those things that can be given to Taruk that he could eat with you if you wanted. If not, just this top book shows you how to make the seasonal feeding system. And that's just what the breakfast is. But pretty much right now you have a great bird largely because he's a baby. As he matures, you really need to have like a firm understanding of training, and the diet's got to be locked in. So I can't stress that enough. So that's your breakfast, this is dinner. And you'll be surprised, like with that food, we'll make a batch, a pretty big batch that lasts us with 9 parrots, that'll last us a month or two.
You pre-make it?
Yeah, we pre-make it and then we put it in Ziploc freezer bags and we just freeze it. So you'll, like however much you would use over a few days, you take that out and defrost it. Mm-hmm. So, you know, kind of make your portions accordingly. So that'll help a ton, and it'll just kind of make sure like that he feels best, especially as you're getting towards free flight. That'll set you up for success for there. The reason that's so important, I've tried to mention a few times, but end up in like heat stroking from today. Rather than having to focus, like a lot of people don't want to fly a parrot because they think you have to have them starved, and that's just not the case.
Right.
So that's what I was trying to explain about the treat value, is like when they eat vegetables and the chop mix for breakfast, the value of the treat is a lot higher because they don't get them unless they're flying.
Right.
So we use that to our advantage, and then, you know, give them a nice cold pressed pellet for the evening. And then on days where, like, let's say you know for sure she got a 12-hour day at the shop and you're not going to be back, but you want to make sure that he eats, you can use some of our toys. So these are out of our subscription package. There's all these different ones. So you hang these in and you just start stuffing pellets in here. So he has to forage to find them. So you're really, you know, kind of going back to nature. You're trying to simulate that in the wild, be flying all day, tearing apart stuff in the hopes of maybe finding food with no guarantee. So in captivity, we actually do our animals a disservice by giving them 24-hour access to food. They need to actually be able to think. So by hiding food in these, I brought several different things. This one's just to destroy.
I feel like this is gonna last a second.
Yeah, you know, and that's a thing. So like when I was growing up, my parents had a blue and gold macaw named Tico, and they said, oh, you know, my parents were like, oh, he loves this toy. He's had it for 20 years. It's like, if you have it 20 years, a bird doesn't like it. Like, it should be gone.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, so we have a toy subscription program, and a lot of this stuff is from that.
Subscription program? What is that?
So you would basically go on to birdtricksstore.com, and you would order, you know, either medium or large size toys, and just once a month we send you a box of new toys, and it's stuff like you don't have to go shopping for.
But it's like a monthly thing?
Yeah, but we go through and we pick the best, so they're all made out of like the best materials, right? So this is all organic, natural type material, as opposed to certain ropes. Like you have a rope toy in there, really watch that rope toy because birds will start to fray it and then they can get caught in it and die.
Hmm.
So if you have rope, make sure it's like this, that's really brittle. But this, you know, you can hide food, treats, nuts in there. So if you're gonna be gone all day, slowly start to introduce foraging. So like make it easy for him, and then you can start to make it a little bit harder. And so he has to work for his food throughout the day if you're not gonna be able to be home to do a training session. So there's a couple of those for you. And this one's massive too. So we'll hide food like just inside of this. And make that, those are great. We also brought you our podcast t-shirt.
Oh, sick.
And I know you don't have a DVD player, but our family-friendly formulas 1 and 2, these are pretty much, if you study these, it's the science of training parrots, but really simplified, so that instead of having to understand antecedent behavior consequence, we just really simplified into here's exactly what to do. So I'll send you the digital files for that too, but we want to leave you with as many tools as we could to help set you up for success, especially because your bird's at such a perfect age right now to be able to benefit from training. But you know, the big thing that we teach everybody is every interaction is a training session. And so when you start to, after you watch that, you'll realize like what you're doing that's accidentally reinforcing or punishing without even knowing it.
Pretty cool. All these things I had no idea about. Yeah, and, only likes one member of your family and wants to kill the rest. It sounds like Toruk right there.
Right? Yeah. You know, if you want to know more about the toy program, you can check it out on our site. But yeah, basically, you want to start trying to put food in there and, yeah, all natural stuff.
Sick, man. I really appreciate you bringing all this stuff.
No worries. Now I got room in my suitcase for my flight home.
That's awesome.
Gonna get some food, take a nap, gonna take a shower. Right? It's been a long day, shooting guns, doing training, eating treats, all that stuff, right? All the stuff that Dave brought me. new food, got some books, got some swag, got some stuff. Can't believe I said swag. It's a horrible word. I don't know why that. I said swag.
Swag.
Swag. I appreciate you though, man.
Yeah, man.
Greatly appreciate it.
My pleasure.
I'm gonna let you know how it goes. We'll stay posted.
He's a good bird, and I'm stoked to see what happens.
Same.
I need to get you out there flying with us on one of our trips. You know, same thing with her. Like, she didn't even know that her bird could fly, actually. And then it flew off, and it was clipped. And then she called us to have us train her. And we were just saying, it's a little over 2 years now, and she's flying almost every day. And it's just neat to see the relationship that people can have with parrots.
Yeah.
So I'm stoked that you're wanting to put in the effort, and obviously you love the heck out of this guy, so
hell yeah. It'll
be fun to see him flying.
Yep.
One more treat before I go